Hello everyone! Today I wanted to start a series on a Python framework I use every day, Django. In this video, I'll go over what Django is and how to get it installed. So what is Django? Django is a web framework. What's a framework? The best description I ever heard of a framework is that it's a collection of tools that you have to use in a specific way in order to get the best results. So it's less like having a toolbox and more like having a couple of modular kits from IKEA. There's many possibilities to what you can do, but there's definitely limitations. Even so, Django is still extremely flexible, allowing for a wide variety of websites to be built on top of it, from a simple blog to a complex collection of data and features like a newspaper. Let's get Django installed. I'm going to assume that you have Python 3 and VirtualEnv Wrapper installed already. Using Python 3 is important since Django will be phasing Python 2 out in the not-so-distant future. First, we need to set up a VirtualEnv. I'm going to be using Python 3, so I need to set that flag. Then, I'm going to pip install Django. To make sure it worked, I'm going to type Django admin. I got the help text rather than an error, so I know I'm good to go. Django admin and manage.py, which you'll see in a bit, are key in managing your Django app. They're what you'll use to create new projects and apps, migrate and dump data, and run the development server. Now that we have Django set up, let's create a new project. In your VirtualEnv, type Django admin start project, and then the name of your project. I'm going to be calling mine Better Reads. You'll see why in the next video. Django will create a new folder with a skeleton project inside of it. Let's go over what's in the project folder. First, we have manage.py. As I said before, we'll be using this script quite a bit to help manage our project. Second, we have a folder with the same name as our project. This folder is going to hold many of the settings that apply throughout our site. Inside that folder, we have a number of files. Settings.py holds all of the settings for our site, like where our database is, where it can find templates, and so on. Urls.py holds all the routing for our project, so that if someone goes to /blog, Django knows to serve up the front page to our blog and not our About Me page. Whiskey.py deals with serving up the site. And you wouldn't really mess with this file until you're ready to deploy your website. Now that we know what all these files are, let's get our database set up. Run python manage.py migrate, and Django will create a new database with some tables in it. Once the database is set up, create a new superuser by typing python manage.py create superuser and following the prompts. Now that we have a database, the last thing we have to do is make sure everything is working by running the test server. Run python manage.py run server, then go to 127.0.0.1:8000 in a browser. You should see this test page. If you go to 127.0.0.1:8000 admin, you should see a login. Use the super user you created earlier to log in. If your login works, then everything is working. And that's all for this video. Next time, we're going to plan out our first app and create some models.